In this video, I'll be showing you how to turn on your Vectorscope and Waveform monitor, as well as how they function within the context of Autodesk Smoke. The purpose of the Waveform monitor and Vectorscope is to give you technical measurements concerning imagery you are working with. For instance, the Waveform monitor allows you to monitor the luminance or brightness of your image. The Vectorscope enables you to measure the color and the color intensity. For more details on how Vectorscope and Waveform monitors work, as well as the mathematical science behind the image analysis, please research technical manuals or websites. So here we have a sequence that has been cut together, and you would like to analyze the technical information of the images. This is to ensure that the brightness and colors are all balanced, as well as maintaining legal specifications that may be required for your deliverable. Firstly, the only way to access the Vectorscope or Waveform monitor is to work in the single player mode. You can click the View Area Layout pull-down menu and select the single player. Now click the Player Options pull-down menu to show the various choices. Please note that the monitoring tools for videos such as Vectorscope and Waveform monitor, as well as the Autodesk options for your sound, will be grayed out if you are not in the player view. Let's choose the Vectorscope option. The new panel that has appeared currently displays the Vectorscope. You can use the panel's pull-down menu to toggle between the Vectorscope and Waveform monitor. Let's start off with the Vectorscope. This is the color representation of your image that you can see in the player. You can see the color balance as well as the color intensity as the lines grow outwards towards the edge of the circle. The Vectorscope will update as I scrub the image, and the Vectorscope will also update in real time as I play the sequence. It's worth mentioning that the Waveform monitor will also update during scrubbing and playback. Now, the Vectorscope can be represented in three ways. Firstly, you have the traditional monochrome Vectorscope. Secondly, you have the 2D color Vectorscope that you will also find in the ConnectFX color warper. This can be used for balancing and manual color matching within the color correction tools. Finally, you have the super uber 3D color cube that represents your color in 3D space, also available within the ConnectFX color warper. This is for laterally minded color thinkers, but we'll focus our attention to the traditional monochrome representations. Next up is the Waveform monitor. Here you can judge the brightness of your image in the technical representation. You can see the brightness of all RGB channels together through the luminance option, or you can monitor individual red, green, and blue channels. I do like to go into the Vectorscope settings and increase the scope's intensity to see a brighter pattern. Now, here are a few technical analysis tips. By default, your scopes are monitoring every value within the image. This is indicated by the field display. And looking at the waveform, there is lots of information densely packed into the scope. To plot any pixel within your image on the scopes, click the Color Sample button. Using the plot cursor, you can click and drag over your image. The pixels you drag over will be shown in the scopes. When you release the cursor, the plot will show the value of the selected pixel at the current frame. Scrubbing or playing the sequence will not update your plot sample. If you want to be even more accurate with your sampling, I suggest going back into the Vectorscope settings and set the field display to line. What Smoke is now doing is, instead of displaying the whole image in the scopes, Smoke is analyzing a single pixel horizontal line. Going back to the color samplers again, when you click and drag vertically over the image, you are choosing which horizontal line is going to display in the scope. Dragging the cursor horizontally at the same time will display the pixel that you are plotting on the horizontal line sample. Incidentally, switching to the Vectorscope will also display the single line analysis with the current pixel sample. So you should be able to identify the values you are sampling. Finally, it's an obvious expectation, but definitely worth pointing out. You select any segment in the sequence and apply a color correction timeline effects using the effects ribbon. When you work with the basic parameters or go into the effects editor, any grading operations you perform on your image will be represented on the scopes.